accomplish in it. And it is dispraise, on the other hand, for those who are negligent of its reality and the shortness of this life. We find that Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he offered Amr ibn al-Has radiyallahu ta'ala anhu arda, a share of the war's spoils, he said, La ya Rasulallah, I don't want the dunya. I'm not after wealth. I only perform the hijrah for the sake of Allah and His Messenger. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam remarked, saying, Ya Amr, ni'ma al-malu al-salih, lil-rajul al-salih. How excellent it is whenever the lawful money is in the hand of the righteous man. This is it. And that's why I'm going to tour you and take you in a tour in a beautiful hadith with a beautiful statement of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the most wise human being ever. He said in a hadith which is narrated by Abu Kafshat al-Anmari radiyallahu ta'ala anhu arda. The hadith is collected by Imam al-Tirmidhi and it is a Hasan hadith, it's a fair hadith. He said the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنَّمَا الدُّنْيَا لِأَرْبَعَةِ نَفَرٍ. Every one of us, whether those who are sitting here right now in the ladies area, or those who are outside in the street, Muslims or non-Muslims, each one of us fits under one of the following categories. Then, after we study the hadith together, I'll let everybody decide, where do you fit? Where do you fit in? Whom do you belong to? And accordingly, you can know exactly your position with Allah and your stand. إِنَّمَا الدُّنْيَا لِأَرْبَعَةِ نَفَرٍ رَجُلٍ آتَاهُ اللَّهُ مَالًا وَعِلْمًا فَهُوَ يَتَّقِي فِيهِ رَبَّهِ وَيَصِلُ فِيهِ رَحِمَهِ وَيَعْلَمُ أَنَّ لِلَّهِ فِيهِ حَقَّ فَهَذَا بِأَفْضَلِ مَنَازِلِ. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, people in this life are four categories. The first category is a man whom Allah blessed with wealth and knowledge. And whenever we address knowledge here, we're talking about the religious knowledge, not biochemistry, not physics, not math. Those are all useful knowledge. But they will never be able to lead the servant to the oneness of Allah and to teach him and instruct him how to worship Allah properly. So we're referring to the religious knowledge. Al-ilm al-shar'i. People in this life are one of four categories. The first is a man whom Allah bestowed upon him wealth and knowledge. So he recognizes Allah's rights in his wealth. He keeps his duties towards Allah in respect of his wealth. And he discharges his duties towards his kinship and upholds the ties of his kinship through his wealth. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam described this class and this man as saying, فَهُوَ بِأَفْضَلِ الْمَنَازِلِ. He is in the best position. Such person is the best man whom Allah blessed with both wealth and religious knowledge. So with the religious knowledge, he knows how to dispense this wealth properly. And the second category is a man whom Allah deprived from wealth, but he bestowed upon him the religious knowledge. So he says, لَوْ أَنَّ لِي مَالًا لَعَمِلْتُ فِيهِ مِثْلَ فُلَانٍ فَهُوَ نِيَّتُهُ فَأَجْرُهُمَا سَوَاءٌ. So he says, if I had any money, I would have done in it the same like so and so, who is in the first category. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, accordingly he will be compensated and rewarded according to his intention. فَهُمَا فِي الْأَجْرِ سَوَاءٌ أَوْ فَأَجْرُهُمَا سَوَاءٌ. He shall receive the same reward of the first man who possessed both wealth and money, whom Allah is pleased with, who is in the best position, even though he did not have the money. Simply, why? Because he intended to do like him. And the third category is a man upon whom Allah bestowed wealth but deprived from the religious knowledge. Wealth bila ilm. فَهُوَ يَخْبِطُ فِي مَالِهِ بِغَيْرِ عِلْمٍ. So, he squatters and And he wastes his wealth without knowledge, without right. He does not recognize any of Allah's rights in it. He does not uphold the ties of his kinship, nor does he discharge his duties toward them. And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said about this person, فَهُوَ بِأَخْبَثِ الْمَنَازِلِ. He is the worst individual. He's been blessed with wealth, but he doesn't know how to use it properly. In order to have an asset that is preserved for him in the hereafter, towards the akhirah. What about the fourth? The fourth is somebody whom Allah did not bestow upon him, neither wealth nor knowledge. So when he looks at the above three individuals or categories, nothing impresses him but the third, the ignorant one who possessed the wealth and the money. And he says, man, if I have money, I would have done like him or even more. Every weekend I would be in Las Vegas. I would gamble. I would have plenty of girls. I would drink. I would do this and this and that. I would show off. So, النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم said, فهو نيته فهما في الوزر سواء. I feel sorry for the fourth person more than anybody else, because he did not have the money. He did not waste it, nor did he spend it in haram, but he will be held accountable similar to the third category because of his intention. فهما في الوزر سواء. Him and the third one are alike in the punishment. Why? Because of his intention. If we examine the four categories, we recognize that what's really praiseworthy in this hadith is not wealth. Because in the third category, we have one who possesses the wealth. But he was disgraced because he possessed the wealth alone. And he did not know what to do with it. And the first one was praised not because of the wealth, rather because of the knowledge, the religious knowledge with which he was able to dispense his wealth properly. That's why the second category, he received the same reward without having to encounter any difficulty of collecting the fund, nor dispensing it. فَهُمَا فِي الْأَجْرِ سَوَاءٌ. Al-Imam Ali ibn Abi Talib, رضي الله تعالى عنه وأرضاه, used to say, كفى بالعلم فخرا أن يدعي من ليس له بأهل وكفى بالجهل عارا أن يتبرأ منه من هو أهله. It is an enough honor for knowledge that even those who are not knowledgeable, they claim knowledge. They like to be knowledgeable even though they are not. And it is an enough disgrace for ignorance that even those who are already ignorant, they try to disown ignorance and disassociate themselves from it by claiming that we're not ignorant. When we examine the Quran, we find في سورة الزمر verse number 9, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قُلْ هَلْ يَسْتَوِ الَّذِينَ يَعْلَمُونَ وَالَّذِينَ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. In a rhetoric question, Allah is asking, are they equal? Are they even? Those who know and those who do not know? Obviously not. في سورة آل عمران, Allah praised the knowledgeable ones by putting their mention in the same verse along with his name. By saying, شهد الله أنه لا إله إلا هو والملائكة وأولو العلم. Who bears witness that there is no God but Allah, Allah himself, and his angels, and the knowledgeable ones. What an honor. وفي سورة محمد, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَاعْلَمْ أَنَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ. الإمام البخاري had a very interesting remark on this ayah. He said, he began by the ilm before at-tawheed, because there is no tawheed without ilm. Through knowledge, through the religious knowledge, we come to recognize the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Because of that, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لا حسد إلا في اثنتين والحديث متفق عليه. It's agreed upon its authenticity. It's collected by Bukhari and Muslim. Envy is absolutely